Hello and welcome back to What Remains of Edith Finch. So Molly has been going on a bit of an adventure here, and now it looks like we're maybe an octopus here on the ferry, and we're going to, she can only go that far. Okay, we can go there. Oh, we can. Not sure what exactly we're doing here, but oh, okay. So we use our tentacle to pull us forward.
Now I was a monster.
Oh,
and
cool.
I smelled people everywhere.
Definitely a monster. Cool.
I was big, but I moved real quiet.
I'm not moving all that quiet. Sorry. Yeah, I'll just stick on it. So we're hoping to get a couple of steps.
I wanted to stop, but also I didn't.
Oh! Yes, we ate him. That's what we're gonna do with the drunken sailor, eh? That was the owl right there, wasn't it? Or wasn't the bird we were chasing the first? Or maybe it was. Just a big picture. I guess we should go eat the other guy then. We left on the grass. Let's chase you around and then we'll go into the wilderness. I don't think we can use the telescope. No. Okay. So we've got to go down and get that light. Coming for you, buddy. Very sorry, but it has to be done. Go. Okay. Molly has a fantastic imagination. She sent the bed with no supper. All this comes into play. Even if it's something that really happened to her, she still must have had the imagination to make it happen in the first place. So we've got to go out and then into the room. Thank you.
hungry, and across the water I saw something new, something I had to have, so I swam towards it.
Nice.
I slithered onto the sand, and the good smell went into an old pipe.
Okay, let's go to the pipe. Oh, nice. Use the ice, whatever it was. It's helpless. Oh, we're into Titan. So we're on the mainland now.
I got closer and closer.
Hang on. This is your bedroom. So we went back the other way. Oh, are we gonna eat your chipmunks? I think we are. So we can't go out the room. Look at this under here. All my stomachs.
All my stomachs started growling. And suddenly, that was me again. I held my breath for a long time, but I couldn't hear anything. I think it's waiting for me to fall asleep. But it's not going to wait much longer. It needs to feed, and we both know I will be delicious.
That was really cool. That was such a cool experience.
I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure Edie would have.
Yeah, I'm not sure I believed all of it either, but it was still a really cool story. So that's Molly. Let's close the book. So we've got a little family tree there in that book as well, it seems. So, is there anything else we can do? So over here is that type. What's going on though? Don't see something in there.
Molly's gerbil had a tiny bedroom with its own even tinier gerbil cage.
Oh, cool. So she looked after gerbil pretty well. So, is there anything
I can't
in here
describe
that's
it,
gonna
but
lead us?
I felt like some part of Molly was still here.
Maybe there is. Molly seemed like a cool kid. That sounded like a cat as well. Let's open the window. Oh, so we get threatened as a person.
This will be obvious later, but my mom never told me any of these stories. Edie would have, but mom didn't like bringing up the past. Though, when we adopted a stray kitten, she was the one who named it Molly.
Oh, cool. So she must have known about Molly's story of turning into a cat. Maybe there was a time when her mother and Edie did actually get on, and Edie used to tell her stories as well. But then something happened to change that. Okay, so let's check in here. Okay, here we go.
I spent a lot of time in Great Grandma Edie's room. We got along, and it was a good place to hide from my mom.
Yes, so Edith really didn't like her mom either. Built 1937, Finch.
When Edie told people Sven was killed by a dragon, She could also have said he was building a dragon-shaped slide that collapsed. She could have, but she didn't.
So that's how he got killed by the dragon then. But yeah, his janky DIY got him killed in the end. Looks like he was originally from Norway though, where the family were, so that's a Norwegian flag there. Dragon kills Finch, tragedy strikes Finch family, something, I don't know. Celebrations turn to whatever. Misery, I guess. Okay, before we go through that door, let's see what else is in the room. So this is Edie's room.
Her room was like a museum.
That's Odin. Odin is her, Edie's father, so Edith's great-grandfather.
For 500 years, the Finches have been famous throughout Norway for their fortune. And misfortune. Odin Finch buries the latest victims of the family curse. His wife, Ingeborg, and their newborn son, Johan.
So his wife and son died, but then I guess, yeah, he obviously had the daughter as well, in Edie, who survived. So that was Edie's younger brother.
On January 7th, 1937, he set sail with his family and his house, hoping to leave the curse behind.
Cool. So he bought his house as well as the family. So this family have been eccentric for a long time then. It hasn't just been Sven.
But 40-foot waves off the coast of Washington send the house and Odin to the bottom of the sea.
Ah, so it sunk before they actually situated it, rather than being situated and then sunk. Okay. And then they took the bricks to make the house that stands there now.
Odin's daughter Edie, with husband Sven and baby Molly, step ashore on their new home, Orcas Island. Odin Finch is the first to be buried in the new family cemetery.
So he must have died on the crossing.
His daughter Edie is already dreaming of a new Finch house.
I like the smiles there. It looks like a scene from the comedy show Home Improvement. And then that's the end. Back up. That was cool though.
Whatever's wrong with this family, it goes back a long ways.
So Odin, now we have as well. So we've got Molly over there on one branch, and then Odin as the basically the beginning of the tree as far as we're concerned. Okay. So let's close the book. Mysteries of Death and Thereafter by Odin Finch. So he wrote a book as well. Cool. Looks like it was one of those where you have to buy so many copies of your own book. So Sven and Edie have their names on there. And they've got, I guess they're, it must be Finches, the birds. One of them has like a bandana, that's cool. And one of them has the construction hat that the other guy had on.
Edie knit me a new pair of gloves every year, just in time to replace the old ones.
Cool. Ah, so she was obviously an artist, and she used the material that she found.
Louis died a week before we left, but Edie had already started to memorialize him.
Now that's a bit weird. So he was alive and she was doing memorials for him. So maybe she sees some kind of precognition. But that is a bit weird. Is there anything else we can see? Joining the great majority. By Odin Finch again. So he was a bit of a prolific writer, I guess. So we've got Edith, Milton, Lewis. Who else? Gregory. Who's that up the top? It's a gal. Walter.
Great grandma had always been the family's biggest fan.
Ah, so she's like the. She's very sentimental. Something else here in the air, it seems. Oh, there's. Is this a singer? We had one of these, so you'd sit down and you'd use your foot on the pedal to make the needle go, and then the handle was for adjusting where it was, if I remember, and then you had all the drawers for your different needles and thread and all that kind of stuff. Cool. That's her one of those tablet things where, because a lot of older people would forget if they take the tablets that day or not. So those are really good. Like, just if there's someone else there, you don't have to keep asking did you take the tablets. You just check whether the one for today is empty or not. Okay, so we came in this way, so it's probably not much more we can see here. Okay, and it looks like we dealt with this side as well. So, why don't we go through the door? Although we haven't looked over here much. Well, we did get about the dragon there. Ah, here we are. Edie won't go. 72-year-old woman refuses to evacuate because of a little forest fire.
One summer, they evacuated the island, but Edie refused to go. For a few weeks, she was a celebrity.
And back then, you can see that the house looks almost normal. It didn't have all of the weird stuff added on to it. So that means that this built 1937, so this whole house was built in 1937. Because this is part of the original house. Oh, we've got more here. One of the old tube televisions. They were massive. They were really heavy. And they were awkward to carry as well, because most of the weight was here in the front, where the screen and the tube was. And in the back was just plastic and mainly kind of air inside. So when you're lifting those, you'd have to carry it from the front side or else you were going to drop it. And we've got loads of...
I hadn't thought of myself as Edith Jr. for a long, long time.
Okay, Mole Man Beneath the Finch House.
Edie gave a big interview about a mole man living under the Finch house. My mom was furious.
So the mother is like Mrs. Practical. The grandmother is just believes everything. Given the type of game it is, I guess there's going to be a grain of truth to what the grandmother felt. But like it can be difficult for someone who is very practical to deal with someone who doesn't use logic when you get in an argument. So I can see why they would clash, because the mother would maybe be trying to argue logically with the grandmother, and then the grandmother would just pluck things out of the air and say, this is why, that's why. And it's just, there's no common ground there. You're not arguing about essentially about the same thing. So it's best not to. I found as well with one of my sisters, it's best not to argue with people like that. If you are of a more practical sense. But anyway, let's press on.
Even in her 90s, sometimes Edie seemed a lot younger than my mother.
Because the mother had a childlike spirit, or the grandmother, Edie, had a childlike spirit, whereas the mother maybe felt that she had to be the practical person in the family. Somebody had to look after that side of things. Not everybody could be the eternal child. Let's go through here. So we've got this,
the only trace Grandpa Sam's first wife Kay left on the house was the pink bathroom.
Yeah, interesting.
It was a pretty big trace.
It was, yeah. Wow. Okay, what have we got over here then? It's nice that they left some toilet roll and it hasn't disintegrated. The key's going to work in there as well. Wow. Multi-purpose key. Although it looks like the same kind of lock. Still, those locks, normally they have a number of different, it might only be a handful, but they normally have a number of different keys that would fit so that not every single lock should open with the same key. There's a secret in this bathroom by Sven and Andy Finch. Cool. Let's find out what it is.
There's a secret in this bathroom.
Oh, a nice pop-up box. Book.
It's in the last place you would look. It isn't in the cupboard. It's hidden in this book.
Oh, cool. I like that. That is really cool. And there we go. So we're into another room then. Oh, and I guess we've no choice about whether we're going through or not. So we're done with the bathroom. Calvin Finch. So this looks like
Sven gave Sam an old camera he'd refurbished. He never put it down.
Sven, or Sam, was the photographer in the family. Let's check if there's anything else. Doesn't look like it. So continue on. I don't want to miss anything. I'm really enjoying the story and I don't want to miss another snippet of story as we progress on. Some people kind of are derogatory about these kind of games and they call them things like walking simulators and that kind of thing. But I think they really missed the point that, someone can just have you moving around in the virtual world and still tell a fantastic story and make it interesting while you're doing it as well. So we've got Milton with the swing there. So Milton was definitely here. Some more bottles. Oh, I know where we are now. I'm in the room where the two kids were one kid had died, and we're, I guess, on the dead. No, we're on the dead kid side, was with the moon and stars. So, we've done Edie's room, so I think this is probably a good place to cut it as we move into another room here. So, Again, if you're enjoying, please consider liking, subscribing, sharing, posting a comment. And I really do hope to see all of you next time. Goodbye.